Hello, welcome back to the OBIS data formatting series. In this video, we will learn how to format data into an event table. We already have our event IDs from the last video, so now we need to identify which information is related to events to include in our table. This will of course be the event ID, parent event ID, event remarks, verbatim event date, day, month, year, event date, station, transect, quadrat, depth, as well as all of our coordinates. And now what about our temperature and velocity measurements? These are abiotic measurements we took at each quadrat. They are measurements associated with an event, the quadrat sample. So for now, we will copy these alongside the event data, but ultimately these will be moved into the extended measurement or fact table. The only other column that we need to include is sampling method. So now we can copy all of these, create a new sheet, name it event, and we will paste the data. So the next thing we want to do is remove all duplicate records. So again, we'll copy everything. This will make sure we are left with only unique events. So from the data tab in Excel, we'll go to remove duplicates, check my data has headers, and make sure only event ID is selected. So that way only events with a unique event ID will be kept. Great. So next we want to make sure all of our field names map to Darwin Core. Most of them already are because we did this in the previous video. The only ones that aren't are station, transect number, quadrat number, depth, and sampling method. So station, transect, and quadrat number don't have a Darwin Core term equivalent, so we will leave these and instead move to depth. There are two Darwin Core depth fields, maximum depth in meters and minimum depth in meters. So we will name this one the maximum depth in meters. If you have both a max and a min, make sure to provide that. And if you have to convert your depth from feet or another unit into meters, please provide the original depth in the field verbatim depth. The sampling method will actually be delegated to three different columns. So we have sampling protocol, sample size value, and sample size unit. Sampling protocol will be equivalent to sampling method, so we can simply just rename this column. For sample size value, the sampling was done in 1 meter by 1 meter quadrats, so the sample size value will be 1, and the associated unit will be a square meter. We can apply this to all of the quadrat events. But we do have to make sure that when we apply, that it's applying correctly. So I'm going to highlight two rows of the same and then drag it down. Now let's go to our documentation tab and note that our sampling method we renamed to sampling protocol. We also have noted depth goes into maximum depth in meters. And we must also note that we added two extra columns for sample size value and sample size unit. Now, I would like to briefly point out here that although our example only has point coordinates for decimal latitude and decimal longitude, if you have a line transect for an event like this, you can also populate the footprint WKT field and the associated footprint SRS field with a well-known text string. Please see our video on using the OBIS map tool's WKT function for guidance on this. Otherwise, our event table is now done and we can format the occurrence table next.